Welcome to the lectures on transportation engineering 2 CA 4.5. In this lecture, we will learn about traffic regulation and traffic control devices. First of all, let's learn what is traffic operation. To operate the traffic in a proper and disciplined way, the two factors are very, very important. One is the traffic regulation and another one is traffic control devices. What is the traffic regulation? The traffic regulation should cover all the aspects of vehicles, drivers, pedestrian, flow, accident, etc. So that the traffic can be regulated in some of the ways. So these are some of the measures by which we can regulate the traffic. Let's see each and every one by one. What are those? There are various traffic regulatory measures. What are those? First one is issuing driving license. This is one of the ways by which we can regulate the traffic. We can control the traffic up to some certain extent. Because without obtaining the driving license, the persons or the peoples are not allowed to drive the vehicles on the road. So this is the issue. The driving license is one of the ways by which we can control the, we can regulate the traffic up to certain extent. Then the registration of vehicle. Similarly, the transfer of ownership, then distinction between the private and public vehicles, transportation authorities, then high speed limits, then limits of weight. We have certain category, we have the category to divide or to classify the vehicles into light commercial vehicle and heavy commercial vehicle. Like the vehicles, those have the laden weight more than 3 tons are classified as heavy commercial vehicle, right? The laden weight less than 3 ton is classified as the light commercial vehicle. On some of the places, we do not allow the entry of heavy commercial vehicle, and somewhere we do not allow the entry of 4 vehicles or something like that. So this is also limit of weight. By that, we can also regulate the traffic up to certain extent. Then parking and holding places, insurance fees, then punishment of violation and offense. Provision of control devices. So these are the certain measures by which we can regulate the traffic. Now let's move to the various traffic control devices. The various traffic control devices are classified into this point, that is signs, that means traffic sign, traffic signal, marking and island. These are the main traffic control devices. So let's say traffic signs, we have the 3 types of traffic signs, that is regulatory signs, warning signs and then informatory signs. In signals, we have different types of signals, that is fixed time signals, manually operated signals, which are operated generally by the traffic police at the junctions, then traffic actuated signals, they are automatically operated traffic signals, then we have the pedestrian signals, which are meant to give the right of way to cross the road for pedestrian, then we have the special traffic signals. In the marking, we have the pavement markings, we have the curb markings, then object markings, reflector unit markings, designators markings. Under the islands, what are the islands? The islands are the structure which are meant to guide the traffic so that the traffic can be regulated and we can control the traffic to maintain the discipline on the roads. So those are the traffic, those are the islands. These are the divisional islands, channelized islands. We have pedestrian loading island, then we have the rotary islands. So let's start with the first traffic control device, that is traffic signs. We have seen in the traffic sign, we have the 3 categories. What are those? One, we have the regulatory signs, then we have the caution, then we have the warning signs, and then we have the informatory signs. So first of all, we will start with the regulatory signs. The regulatory signs are generally mean to inform the road users about certain laws, regulations and prohibitions. If the drivers of the vehicle will not follow these traffic rules and regulations, or particularly these traffic signs, then it will be considered as the legal offense, and the vehicle and the driver of the vehicles will be penalized for that. So in that, in this category, that is regulatory sign, these regulatory signs are also known as the mandatory signs. In this category, we have further divided the sign into these categories. Those are the stop and give way sign, then we have prohibitory sign, then we have no parking signs, Then we have speed limit and vehicle control signs, restriction and sign, compulsory direction control and other signs. Stop signs are mean to stop the vehicle at that particular place, while prohibited signs are mean to prohibit the certain traffic movement at that particular place. No parking signs, vehicles are not supposed to park, or they are prohibited to park the places, or they are prohibited to park the vehicle at that particular places. Speed limit, they are to restrict the speed limit, restriction and signs, and we have control compulsory direction control sign. They are to force the vehicle to particularly follow that direction or that type of sign. So we have a stop signs. This is the sign for traffic. This is the stop sign, which is octagonal in shape. It is background is red color, while the border is white, and in between it may be written STOP or it may not be written. So the stop sign is octagonal in shape, red background and white border. While this is the giveaway sign, this is straight prohibit. These are the prohibitory signs. You can see these are the signs for one way direction signs. These are the prohibited signs. Similarly, we can see here the left turn prohibited, this is U-turn prohibited, this is overtaking prohibited, no horn, this is no parking, this is no stopping, means vehicles are not stopped at that particular place. This is the speed limit sign to restrict the speed limits. 50 it is mentioned, that means the maximum speed that can be followed at that particular place is 50 meter, that is width limit. The width limit of the vehicle should not be more than 2 meter. If 2 is written, this is 3.5. This is the weight limit, that is 5 ton. Similarly, these are the buses only on a particular road. Only the buses are allowed. These are the regulatory signs. Then we have the warning signs. The warning signs are generally the cautionary signs. They are used to inform or to inform the road user about the certain hazards which they can face on their road ahead. Generally, they are generally triangle in the shape. They are generally triangle in that their shape is used to be the equilateral triangle. They used to be the triangle. They used to be an equilateral triangle with the apex upward. They are generally involved a certain distance before that kind of situation. Generally, they are installed 120 meter before in case of national highway or the state highway. 90 meter before in case of major district road. 60 meter before in case of other district road. And 40 meter before in case of the village roads. These are the warning signs. This means right hand curve. Further, they can expect a right hand curve. This is the left hand curve. Right, they have been bent. This type of sign generally we can see in case of the belly area or the knee area. This is left, they have been bent. That is right, reverse bend. That is narrow bridge. This is gaping median, narrow road. Road wider, cycle crossing, pedestrian crossing, school, these are the some of the warning signs. Then we have the informative signs. These signs are used to guide or to inform the road users along the routes, and then inform them about their destination and provide with the information to make their travel easier, safer and pleasant. This informative signs are further divided into these categories, that is direction place identification signs, facilities information signs, other useful information signs, parking signs, flood gauges. Direction places identification sign means if they are quite roughly, we can see at so many places on the national highway that this particular city is this much kilometer ahead. This kind of sign whatever we see, those are the direction and place identification sign, this much kilometer ahead. That is the showing about the distance, as well as this city is straight. For this particular city, the left turn for this particular city, the right turn, that is direction and place identification sign. Then facility information like petrol pump ahead, some food, some eating place ahead, parking facility ahead. These are about the facility information signs. Similarly, other useful information sign, then parking sign, the parking facility ahead, the flood gauges. At particular bridges or at particular canal where the bridge is constructed, we generally keep a sign. We generally keep a sign board which shows the maximum the flood level reach in that at that particular bridge or at that particular place in the last 20 or 50 or 30 years. So these are some of the informative signs: public telephone, petrol pumps, hospital, first aid post, eating places, light place, light refreshment, resting places, through roads, through and side roads. This is park this side particularly at that place. Parking lot, scooter and motorcycle. This, that is, the parking lot is available only for these two wheelers. Then parking lots for cycles. Similarly, the parking lots for cars. Yeah, the informant addition. Identity direction, place identification signs. Similarly, Jaipur, Gurgaon ahead, truck, lay-by, toll booth ahead, Chandigarh is this side, Meerut this side, Agra, Jaipur, Ambala ahead, 202 km. They are the informative signs. Then we have the traffic signals. What is the traffic signals? The traffic signals, these are the signals which are installed at the intersection where the huge amount of traffic is approaching at the intersection, and when the huge amount of traffic is approaching at the intersection, we can expect the collision, rear end collision and accident just because of the huge traffic or the huge amount of traffic. So to avoid these collisions and accident we provide the orderly movement of traffic that can be achieved by installing these traffic signals. So what is the definition of traffic signal? The traffic signals are the control devices which will alternately direct the traffic to stop and proceed at the intersections using red and green traffic light signals automatically. We have the certain advantages of these signals as well as some limitation. Each and every, if you are talking about each and about anything, it always, if it has certain advantages, definitely it will be having certain limitations. Similarly, we will discuss for the traffic signals, it has a certain advantage, so it also has certain limitations. So let's have first the advantages of signals. What are those? As we are saying that it is providing orderly movement of traffic. Means as the vehicles are approaching at the intersections, they have to stop for a certain period of time. And then once they will get the go indication, or to say once the green light will flash, they will get the right of way to cross that intersection. So for that amount of time they can cross the intersection. But once the light will turn to the green, again they have to stop for a certain period of time. During that amount of time they have to bring green light for some other track, for some other cross road. So those vehicles will get the right of way for that duration of time. So for that particular time the vehicles have to stop at this particular place. So that will be, so what they are doing, they are providing the orderly movement, means they will get the green light, they will get the right of way for certain amount of time, again they have to stop, again they will get the green light, means again they will get the right of way. So what they are doing, they are providing the orderly movements. Once the vehicles, those are coming on road 1, they are getting right of way. After that, the vehicles, those are coming on road 2, they are getting right of way. After that, the vehicles, those are coming on road 3, they are getting right of way. So vehicles are getting the orderly movement. So what we are doing, we are providing the orderly movement of traffic. So what will happen due to this? Due to this providing, just because of providing this orderly movement, the traffic handling capacity at the intersection will also increase. As well as we can minimize the collision and as well as the accident at that particular place. Then signals are easy to understand as compared to traffic police management at the intersection, because we know that at this particular place we can see the traffic signs, and accordingly everyone, we are the educated person, as we can understand the meaning of those traffic sign. Green means I am taking the right of way to cross this intersection. If there is red light, that means the person or the vehicle or the driver of the vehicle has to stop at that particular place. So it's easy to understand the traffic signal as well as it's easy to understand the traffic situation rather than the indication given by the traffic police person. So many times just because of traffic, the vehicle driver of the vehicle may not be able to see the traffic police, then it may create the confusion that ultimately causes the collision or the accident. So the traffic signals minimizes the accident just because of it's easy to understand them. Then they allow the crossing of heavy traffic flow with the safety. Automatic signals, if we are using the automatic signals, they proves to be the economical. Then we have certain limitation also for the traffic signals. What is that? The fast moving vehicle may cause the rear end collision. Just because of as we see, if it is when it is a green time, the vehicles that means the vehicles are having right of way to cross that intersection. If the fast moving vehicles, they are traveling at suppose 300 meter, 350 meter before, they saw that there is a green time. That means they have the right of way to cross that particular intersection. They will increase, they will accelerate their vehicle to cross that or to jump that particular intersection. Immediately, if this turns to the red light, means after flashing of yellow light for a duration of 2 seconds, it will turn to the it may turn to the red light. And then if the fast for the fast moving vehicle, it will be difficult to bring their vehicle in the stop condition or to stop their vehicle within that short amount of time. Then this type of situation causes the rear end collision. Similarly, the improper design of signal, improper design of cycle lane also causes certain delay. Suppose we have designed for a duration of 90 seconds, a particular cycle length. The cycle length means the amount of time, time period for which the red light will be displayed. Then 2 seconds of time of amber. Then it will turn for the green light. And again, the amber light will be placed for a duration of 2 seconds, and then the red light will come. Means, if we see a cycle of a traffic signal,
one will be of this side vehicle crossing,
and another will be the vehicles. This will be the another approach length. Suppose we have considered the 90 second as a cycle length, and we have designed the traffic traffic signal timings by considering 90 second as a cycle length. For this duration, this 90 second may not be sufficient for the vehicle approaching on this side, or this may be more than sufficient for the vehicle coming for the vehicle approaching on this side. And what will happen here? Suppose the 60 second is sufficient, then for 30 second there will be the rest of time. Why? The vehicle those are approaching on this side, the 90 second may not be sufficient for crossing all the particular vehicles. So what will happen here? The time is getting waste on this particular layer, but here the 90 second cycle length is causing the delay on this particular road side, on this particular layer. So this will cause the delay, because here suppose 120 second is required for crossing, but we have designed a cycle length for 90 second only. So this 30 second, some of the vehicle will left out to cross this particular junction, to cross this particular intersection. This 30 second amount of time will cause the traffic jam or some accumulation of some of the vehicles on this particular road. This will cause the further delay. Similarly, so these are the two limitations. So now let's move to third limitation. What is that? The failure of signal due to the electric power may result in the confusion of the people. That may cause that may result in the accident or the collision of the vehicle. Next we have the classification of traffic signals. We have three types of traffic signal. One is fixed time signal, pedestrian signal, and traffic actuated signal. In the fixed signals are set to repeat regularly a cycle of red, amber, and green lights. In this, we generally, first of all, we do the traffic survey. We try to find out the traffic volume. Corresponding to the traffic volume, we design the traffic signals and we find out the cycle length. And that particular cycle length is only repeat again and again and again, irrespective of how much the volume of traffic or how much traffic is approaching at that particular intersection. Suppose we have done a traffic volume and we have find out for a particular duration of 1 hour, the peak the traffic volume is 990 or 1000 vehicle per hour. So we have designed that that particular traffic signal by considering 1000 vehicle per hour, and accordingly the cycle length will be determined. And the whole day or the daily, that particular cycle length will repeat again and again, irrespective of how much traffic is approaching at that particular place. Suppose the 1000 vehicles may be approaching in the morning peak hour as well as in the evening peak hour, but during the afternoon, like 11 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, 300 or 400 vehicles per hour, that might be the traffic volume at that time. But during the afternoon also, that much cycle length will only get repeated again and again. That's what is the fixed time signals. Why pedestrian signals? The pedestrian signals are meant to keep the right of way to the pedestrian to cross that particular road. During this much amount of time, the vehicular traffic are supposed to be is compulsorily meant to be stopped at that particular signal by using the stop signal. Then we have the traffic actuated signal. In this, these are in this, the timing and the phase and the phase and the time and the cycle length of the signals gets changed or the vary accordingly depending upon the number of traffic approaching at a particular intersection. These are very costly, as this requires so much computer operation, as well these are generally connected to the computer, and the computer generally operate, and then it generally set as well as it generally change the cycle length depending upon the traffic volume. Then we have some of the terminologies related to traffic signals. We have traffic time cycle, traffic phase, and vehicular phase. Pedestrian phase, after this we have already learned the time cycle. What is the time cycle? This is the total time required, including the amber time, that is initial amber, clearance amber, green time plus red time. That means amber, number, then this is the red. So this overall time, this is called time cycle or cycle length. What is traffic phase? It is a part of time cycle allotted to any traffic movement receiving the right of way. That is called the traffic phase. Suppose out of this, this is the green time. For this much time, the traffic on that road is getting the right of way to cross that particular intersection. So this will be what? This will be the traffic phase. And this also we have the two more term, that is the vehicular phase and pedestrian phase. The vehicular phase will be is a part of traffic phase during which is allotted for the vehicular traffic, that is for the movement of vehicular traffic. Similarly, the pedestrian phase, it will also be a part of traffic phase which is allotted for the movement of or for the crossing of pedestrian, exclusively for the pedestrian only. So that is the pedestrian phase. If there is, we have not provided or we have not allotted any time for the crossing of pedestrian, then the vehicular phase will, the time of vehicular phase will be equal to the traffic phase. Then we have signal system. We have four types of signal system: simultaneous system, alternate system, then we have simple progressive system and flexible progressive system. What is the simultaneous system? Suppose we will take an example of a road. Suppose this is road. On this road we have suppose three signals. One signal, signal number 2, signal number 3, and let's have one more signal, signal number 4. Let's suppose this is 4, 3, 2, 1. What the simultaneous system says that at a point along this given road, at a particular instant, let's call the particular instant is 10 hour, at this particular 10 hour along this given road, if this signal number 1 turns to green, then at this particular time is all the signal number 2, signal number 3, signal number 4, all will turn to the green. All will turn to the green, all will just illuminate the go indication for the vehicle. This is the simultaneous system. All the signals along given road always shows the same signal at the same time. Then we have the alternate system. In this, the alternate signals or the group of signals indicates their opposite sign, means at the particular instant of time or at the same time. Means at this particular time, instant time, that is 10 hours, if the signal number 1 turns to the green, then the signal number 2 will turn to red, this will turn to green, this will turn to red. The alternate signal or the group of signals indicates the opposite signals or opposite indications at along the same route at a particular time or at a same time or at an instant time. This is the alternate system. Then we have simple progressive system. Progress system, again we are taking the same example. Suppose we have four signals, signal number 1, signal number 2, signal number 3, here you have signal number 4. In the under the simple progressive system, we design the signal in such a way that suppose at a particular time, if this signal number 1 turns to the green, then we will do the calculation, we will be knowing this distance, this will be certain distance t. We have a design speed for that road also. So we will try to find out the time we require for the vehicle to reach from this place to this place. That we can calculate, that we can find out the time required for this vehicle to reach from the signal number 1 to signal number 2. So we will design the signal number 2 in such a way that this will turn to green after, suppose this required 40 seconds to reach at this particular place. So this signal number 2 will turn to green after 40 seconds of after 40 seconds of the signal number 1 stops the displaying green. Suppose at this stops this green turns to the amber at suppose 10 hours 20 seconds. Then this will and this required to reach 40 seconds to reach at the signal number 2. So this signal number 2 will turn to the green at the 10 hours 01 minutes. In such a similarly, we will try to find out the time required for the vehicle to reach from signal number 2 to signal number 3. And similarly, we'll design the cycle length as well as this phase of the similarly starting phase for signal 3. So once this vehicle will reach at the signal number 3, this signal number 3 will turn to green. Similarly, this will turn to green, the signal number 4. So this is what the simple progressive system. While in case of flexible progressive system, this generally considers the actuated traffic signal. In this, the cycle length as well as traffic phase vary automatically depending on the number of traffic volume approaching at the particular intersection. Generally, these signals are connected with the computer and computer do all the calculation, and accordingly the traffic phase and traffic cycle length generally vary. Then we have flashing beacons. We have two types of flashing beacons. One is flashing red, another one is flashing yellow. What is the flashing red? During flashing red, the vehicles, those are approaching at that particular intersection, are supposed to stop before the zebra line. The vehicles are stopped before the zebra line, then understand the situation, try to see the situation, how many vehicles are approaching, is there any traffic, is there any pedestrian traffic or other kind of traffic. They need to understand the situation, they need to optimize the situation and then proceed further, and then how to say they cross the intersection with the caution at the slow speed. That is the flashing red. While in case of flashing yellow, the vehicles are not mandatory to stop before the zebra crossing. While passing through intersection, they can proceed further with the caution just by observing the scenario as well as the situation on that particular intersection. Now let's design a signal timing as per the IRC method. This is what the question given to us. We have given the right angle intersections where the turns are prohibited. The road one is 12 meter wide, it is 4 lane. Road number 2 is 7.2 meter wide, it is 2 lane divided. Then we have the volumes on the particular roads are given. On the road 1 we have the 925 vehicle per hour and 750 vehicle per hour. And on road 2 we have the traffic volume as 290 vehicle per hour and 190 vehicle per hour. We are asked to design the signal timings as per IRC method, as well as we have to draw the signal phasing and Venn diagram. So let's draw a figure. First of all, what is given? We are given that 290 with road 1, 925, let's take this as road 1. So it's saying that 925 vehicle is approaching in this direction. While 750 vehicle is from this direction. This is 4 lane as well as this is 12 meter wide. Road 1, this is road 2, 7.2 meter, the vehicles or the traffic on this 290 vehicle and 190 vehicle, this is 290 VPH, this is 190 VPH. This is 4 lane. This is two length. This is what given in the problem. We are asked to find out this, or we are asked to design the signal timings as per IST method, as well as to draw the signal phasing and the bend diagram. Let's start the problem. First of all, we will calculate the pedestrian clearance time on road 1. We are calculating first of all for this. Pedestrian clearance time on road 1. We want to find out pedestrian clearance time on this road 1. In the problem, the width of this road is given. This pedestrian across this pedestrian clearance time means once the pedestrian will start walking from here, how much time will be required to reach at this point on the road 1. The pedestrian clearance time on road 1. We know the width of this road 1 is nothing but the 12 meter divided by, as per the ISD, the ISD says that for the minimum speed of the pedestrian while crossing the road should be 1.2 meter per second. It must be 1.2 meter per second. A pedestrian must follow minimum speed of this while crossing a road. So, minimum speed for the pedestrian crossing a road, it should be 1.2 meter per second. So, we will calculate the pedestrian clearance time, 12 meter divided by 1.2, then we will get the 10 second. Then, we will try to find out minimum green time for pedestrian on road 1. It will be 10 seconds. That is the minimum time required for a pedestrian to cross the road 1, plus we have to add the 7 seconds. The 7 seconds is the initial walk period. It is the initial walk period suggested by IRC. That means that once the pedestrian sign will turn on, this will be the minimum time required for the pedestrian to understand that he has received the right of way to cross that particular road and to start his walking on the road. For that is called the initial walking period. For that, he requires minimum 7 seconds of time, which is suggested by the IRC. So we have to add this 7 seconds here. The total original minimum green time required for the pedestrian to cross the road 1, it will be 10 plus 7, that is 70 seconds. In a similar way, we will try to find out the pedestrian clearance time required on the road 2. Pedestrian clearance time on road 2. This will be the width of this road 2 is 7.2 meter. 7.2 divided by 1.2, this is 6 seconds. Similarly, the minimum break time for pedestrian on road 2. This will be 6 plus 7. This will be 30 seconds. Now we calculate the critical volumes on the road 1 as well as on road 2. While calculating the critical volumes, we will consider the maximum volume. On the road 1, we are reading the maximum traffic, that is 925 vehicles per hour. So whatever the minimum time period is required for this 925 vehicle per hour, that will be definitely suitable for this 750 vehicle per hour. Similarly, whatever time you will design on this road 2 for this 290 vehicle per hour, that much time will be definitely suitable for this 190 vehicle per hour, because the time required for this 190 vehicle per hour will be definitely lesser than the 290 vehicle per hour. So first of all, let's calculate the critical volume on this road 1. Critical volume on road 1, this will be 925 because we have this 925 divided by 2, this will be 462.5 will get, will divide 925 by 2 will get 462.5. So we will take it one full number, so we will take it 463 vehicle per hour. Similarly, we will try to find out the critical volume on road 2. This will be automatically only 290 vehicle per hour. Now we will calculate the minimum green time on road 1. Minimum green time on road 1. This will be the critical volume on road 1 divided by the critical volume on road 2 into the minimum pedestrian clearance, minimum pedestrian green time on the road 1. So what it will be? This will be the 463, that is the critical volume on road 1 divided by the critical volume on road 2, that is 290, multiplied by minimum green time for pedestrian on road 1, that is the 17 seconds. So if you solve this, we get the 27.14 second. Let's call this 28 second. Here, this is what we got, the green time required on road 1. Now we will try to find out the cycle length or the time cycle. For finding the time cycle, we have to add the clear initial umber time of 2 second as well as the clearance umber of 2 second. So right, adding umber time, then time cycle will be 2, that is pedestrian green time is 17 seconds, that must be the green time on road 2. So we have to add 2 and 2 seconds, that is initial umber as well as clearance umber. So 2 plus 17 plus 2 plus the green time on the road 1 is 28 seconds. We have to add the initial umber and the clearance umber of 2 seconds for this time also. So it will be again 2 plus 28 plus 2. If we take the summation of all these things, it will be 53 seconds. This is the 53 seconds. Now, this time cycle length we want in the multiple of 5. So, we have to take the next immediate higher multiple of 5. Next immediate multiple higher of this will be that which is divisible by 5, that will be the 55 seconds. So, let's take this 55 seconds. So we will find out the cycle length as 55 seconds for this particular signal. Now here, actually for this the cycle length was required 53 seconds, but we have made it as 55 seconds. We have increased the cycle length by 2 seconds. So we have to divide this 2 seconds somewhere. So we will try to apportion this extra 2 seconds for once as 1 second on here, for that is green time for road 1. Similarly, we will provide 1 second for green time to the minor, to say on the road 2. So, this 2 seconds will be divided as, is divided as 1 second for road 1 and 1 second for road 2. Therefore, the green time on road 1 is 28 plus 1 equals to 29 seconds. The minimum green time required when the road 1 is 29 seconds, but while the cycle length is as 55 seconds. So let's draw a table. Initial. Number. Then we have the green time. Then clearance number. Then red time. And then the time cycle, how to say the cycle length. Cycle length for road 1 and then for road 2. For road 1, we have the green time as 29 seconds. Initial number is 2 seconds, clearance number is 2 seconds, and we know that total cycle length is 55 seconds, so we can get the minimum red time required on the road 1. So this minimum red time on the road 1, it will be just 22 seconds. So this 22 seconds will be the green time plus initial number and clearance number for the road number 2. So we will divide it. This will be 2 seconds plus 2 seconds. After out of 22 seconds, the 4 seconds is apportioned. So how much time is remain? 18 seconds. So this will be the green time for road 2. If we deduct out of 55 this call, we will get the red time on the road 2. So this will be the 33 seconds. So after getting this, we can draw the same signal facing and the Venn diagram. For the road 1, this is the number of 2 seconds. This is the green of 29 seconds. Then this is again number of 2 seconds. Then this will be the red of 22 seconds. Similarly for road 2, number of 2 seconds. Then this will be the green time of 18 seconds. Then this will be again number of 2 seconds, then this will be the red time of 33 seconds. So this will be the signal facing and band diagram. So like this, we can design the signal timings as per the IRC method.